Hello everyone, I am going to start a course on digital system design using Verilog HDL. This course is very useful for undergraduate, postgraduate and research scholars to learn and explore the field of VLSI. This course is divided into number of parts to simplify the understanding of this course with suitable examples. This particular lecture deals with the first part of this course. This part contains the introduction to Verilog HDL. The contents of this lecture are given as introduction to Verilog HDL, history of Verilog, features of Verilog, design flow in VLSI, comparison between the hardware and software languages, structure of Verilog, abstraction levels, and basics of Verilog. Verilog means verify logic and HDL means hardware description language. So Verilog HDL is hardware language to verify the logic. This topic is related to VLSI circuit designing. VLSI is a category of integrated circuits or ICs where large number of components are fabricated on a silicon wafer. Logic circuits should be verified before fabrication on silicon wafer to reduce the chance of failure of ICs or deviation of the logic functionality as assumed initially. There are different methods to verify the VLSI logic circuits. HDL is one of them. In HDL, VHDL and Verilog are two popular hardware languages. The objective of both languages are same, means model the hardware, but these are differ in style, way of code, syntax and the founding agencies. VHDL is developed in 1981 by the Department of Defense, USA. Initially, HDLs are used for digital circuit designing, but now analog circuits can be verified using VHDL and Verilog AMS extensions. All VLSI designing related softwares are called Electronic Design Automation or EDA tools. HDL software are also the part of EDA tools. History of Verilog HDL. Gateway Design Automation developed Verilog in 1983. Cadence Design System purchased Gateway Design Automation in 1989. This language came in public domain after the approval of IEEE in 1995. Some packages are included in 2001 and then it was IEEE 1364 to 2001 standard language. Features of Verilog HDL. It is very difficult or impossible to verify the VLSI circuit manually or using breadboards because complexity of VLSI circuits are very high. Verilog is used for verifying the complex circuit prior to the implementation. The important feature of Verilog is that it is independent of technology node. The same logic circuit can be implemented on different technology nodes without any change. Other EDA tools are technology dependent and verify the logic circuits at semantic and layout levels. Examples of few such EDA tools are Smart Spice from Silvaco, Aldo from Mentor Graphics, Spectre from Cadence, HSpice from Synopsys. The other important feature of Verilog is that it is vendor independent. The same Verilog code will be run on any tool irrespective of the companies. Verilog convert the customer's demand or requirement to register transfer level or RTL level. It means specifications are converted in form of digital components like registers, adders, multiplexers and number of such digital circuits. The functionality of the logic circuits are tested here and RTL is modified if target functionality is not achieved. RTL is obtained using HDL pre-synthesized tools. A gate level netlist comes after the synthesizing the RTL by using post-synthesizing tool in HDL. This diagram shows the complete flow of VLSI circuits from the design specification to fabrication or implementation. This diagram shows clearly the use of Verilog language to convert the design specification into RTL. Design specifications consist the customer's demand, required functionality of the digital circuits, ideas, overall architecture. Behavioral description reflects the Verilog code of the specifications in terms of functionality and performance. Then a graphical model called RTL is obtained using pre-synthesized tool or manual process. This RTL consists digital circuits in order to meet the circuit requirement. RTL is verified for functionality, then used for generating gate level netlist with the help of post-synthesis HDL tools. Gate level netlist defines the connection between the circuit elements, and automatic placement routing tools take this gate level netlist to create the layouts. Verification is required at different stages like RTL level, gate level and physical layout level to ensure the error-free fabrication of integrated circuits. Comparison between Verilog and C languages. Both are the languages where the Verilog is used for modeling of the hardware, while C language is used for development of softwares. Verilog is used for hardware model, so there is no concept of sequential execution of the instructions. All blocks should be executed parallelly, and Verilog is synthesizable, while C language is not synthesizable. Structure of Verilog uses the concept of module. Module is a simple box showing only input and output terminals or informations. There is a proper format in Verilog. Each Verilog code must start with the keyword module and last with the keyword end module. Verilog is case sensitive and lowercase characters are allowed in Verilog. The basic structure of Verilog code is shown as it is started with the keyword module followed by the module name, that is the identifier, and it is user defined module name. Then in a bracket, input and output information is mentioned. Input and output are separately displayed here to find out the number of inputs and number of outputs. Red color words are the keywords reserved in the Verilog library. Logic function or logic operation in between the program. And there are four ways to decide or declare the logic operation. These four ways are called abstraction labels in Verilog. Module name does not consist any space inside and must start with a letter or underscore sign. It can be a combination of letter and digits. User defined words are called identifiers, and reserved keywords cannot be used as an identifier. The allowed and not allowed module names are given here. Letter and underscores are used to initialize module name, and not allowed module names, we cannot start module name with the digit or using a special character like dollar sign. Dollar sign can't be used at start because it represents system task. Abstraction labels. There are four abstraction labels in Verilog. Abstraction labels show the ways or methods to model the hardware. The lowest level is switch level, where individual switches like NMOS, PMOS or CMOS are used. Number of logic gates like AND, OR, NOT, NAND, NOR, XOR, XNOR, buffer, tri-state are already defined in Verilog library and used at gate level modeling. These are also the reserved keyword in Verilog. If device density is further increased and it is not possible to model the hardware at gate level, then Boolean equations are used for model the hardware. This abstraction level is called data flow level. At data flow level, the most frequent used keyword is assign. Behavioral level is the highest level of Verilog, containing large circuits and large functionality. It is the popular modeling style in Verilog, and behavior of algorithm is mentioned at this level. Initial and always keywords are used in behavior modeling frequently. There are number of basic concepts in Verilog which we have to keep in mind before writing a Verilog code. The important basic concepts are presented here, such as commands, different number representations, Verilog data value set, nets and register data types, identifiers, keywords, vector, arrays, operators, delay and system task. I am discussing each and every concept one by one with suitable examples. First concept is comment. Comment can be mentioned in a code to improve the understanding. Comment can be a single line comment or multiple line comment, and the representations are different. For single line comment, two forward slash signs are used as shown in this example, and it goes up to the end of that particular line. Multiple line comment are shown by the combination of forward slash and star before the starting of the comment and the star and forward slash at the end of the comment. There is uniform format for the number representation in Verilog. Four types of number systems are widely used in digital circuits, and these are binary, octal, decimal and hexadecimal. The format is shown here: size, tick, base and number. Size is decimal equivalent of the total number of bits. Base B used for binary, O for octal, D for decimal and H for hexadecimal. If base and size are not mentioned in a number, then default values will be taken out. Default base is decimal and default size is simulator based and at least 32 bit long. Underscore sign used only for readability purpose and it is not simulated by the simulator. Examples of number systems are given here. Next concept is data value set. There are total 4 data values and these are 0, 1, X and Z. 0 used for logic low, 1 used for logic high, X is unknown or don't care and it will be either 0 or 1, and Z is high impedance. The value of Z is in between 0 and 1. NATS data type. There are 2 data types in Verilog and these are NATS and registers. NATS are continuous driven data type, while registers are used for holding the values. Most of times, NATS are used in combinational circuits, while registers are used in sequential circuits. But this is not a condition. Uses of both data types are depending on the application or functionality of the logic circuits. Wire keyword is used for NATS, while RAG keyword is used for registers. The default values for NATS is Z and X for registers. This program depicts the uses of NATS data types. And here Boolean function is AB plus BC. So why for implementing this Boolean function, we require 2 AND gates and 1 OR gate. And the output of first AND gate is W1, output of second gate is W2. These are continuous driven signals. And here we mentioned W1 and W2 as the wires. So the program is simply showing that module, that is keyword, and identifier example. Input terminals are here ABC and output is Y. Separately, input are ABC and output is Y. Intermediate terminals are W1 and W2, that is wire. And here 2 AND gates are used. So labeling is must. First gate, this one is AND gate A1, this one is AND gate A2. So AND gate label A1, and output of this AND gate is W1, inputs are A and B. So code will be output terminal, that is W1, and inputs AB. Second AND gate label A2, output of this AND gate is W2, inputs are B and C. And here one OR gate is used, so there is no need of labeling this OR gate. So OR, output of this OR gate is Y and inputs are W1, W2 and module. This program is based on gate level modeling because we are using logic gates available in the Verilog library to code this Boolean function. This program shows the use of RAG data type. RAG data type used for holding a values for certain time. So it is widely used for sequential logic circuits. So here keyword module, then we have this program is written for D flip-flop, and condition is there in that D flip-flop, input is D, output is Q, and based on this clock output is equal to input signal. And here we are assuming that when clock is at positive edge, then output is returned to the input signal. So it is not a continuous driven signal. It holds the values for some time. Identifiers are user defined, while keywords are the reserved keywords in the Verilog library. When data is more than 1 bit, then it is called vector and defined by the square brackets, and the width of the vector is the difference between the values. Here example is given, data type is reg and identifier is example, and it is a vector of 8 bits, 7 to 0. Here MSV is showing 7 and LSV side is showing 0. So this vector graphically we represent like this. It is containing 8 bits and MSV is at 7 and LSV at 0 bit. Arrays are the same data type. Elements are also defined by the square bracket after the variable. Array may be one dimensional or multi-dimensional. So examples are given here for one dimensional and two dimensional. Data type is reg here. Identifier is example. And after example, here array is 0 to 3. The graphical representation of this example is given as. And this example is for two dimensional array. Data type is here reg. Identifier is example. And two dimensions are 3 to 0 and 7 to 0. Graphical representation is like this. Verilog allows number of operators and each operator is shown by a symbol. This table shows important operators in Verilog language. Plus sign used for addition operation, minus sign used for subtraction operation, star for multiplication, and forward slash for division, two star used for power, and percentage for modulus. These operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, power, and modulus, these are the arithmetic operators. Then question mark colon, this one is the conditional operator. Curly bracket, concatenation operation. Two curly brackets used for replication. Less than equal, greater than equal. These are relational operators. Two equal signs, not equal, three equal signs, not two equal signs. These are equality operators. Bitwise not, bitwise and, bitwise or. Bitwise or XOR, bitwise XNOR. These are bitwise operators. Right shift, left shift, arithmetic right shift, arithmetic left shift. These are shifting operators. Logical NOT, logical and logical OR, used for logical operations. Examples for arithmetic operators. If A is 2 bit number 01, B is 3 bit number 101, C is 4 bit number 1010, D is decimal equivalent number 42, and E is decimal equivalent number 8. Then this operation y equal to a plus b, simply showing the addition process, addition operation a plus b, and the result will be 3 bit number and number will be 110. Next operation is subtraction operation, and b minus a. B is 101 and a is 01, so subtraction result is 100, that is binary equivalent number. A star B, this one is multiplication operation, and result will be multiplication of 01 and 101, so output will be 101. This operation is division operation, DYE. D is 42 and E is 8, so here quotient value is 5. So this operation provides the quotient value and output Y is equal to 5. D percentage E, this one is modulus process, and here remainder portion is mentioned. 42 modulus 5, so remainder is 2, so output will be 2. Y is D double star E, this one is power operation, So result will be 42 to power 5. The syntax for conditional operator is condition or expression. If this condition is or if this condition or expression is true, then this operation will be completed. Otherwise, this operation is completed. The example is given here for 2 to 1 multiplexer. In 2 to 1 multiplexer, suppose I0 and I1, these are the two input lines, and cell is the selection line. Condition is given here when cell is equal to 0. If this condition is true, then I0 is selected at the output signal. If this condition is not true, it means cell is equal to 1. Then I1 is selected at the output side. So this one is the 2 into 1 multiplexer using conditional operator. Concatenation operator used for joining the numbers. Examples are given here. Y equal to concatenation operation ABC. ABC are given here. A is 2 bit number, B is 3 bit number, C is 4 bit number, and these numbers are in binary. So Y will be 2 bit plus 3 bit plus 4 bit, total 9 bit number, and number will be 01, that is A, 101, that is B, 1010, that is C. Second example is A, B1, C2, 3. Here we are taking all bits of A, 1 bit from B and 2 bits from the C, and 1 is showing here bit position, 2, 3 are showing bit position 2 and 3 for the number C. So here this one is 2 bit number, this one is 1 bit, total 3 bit, 2 bits from C, total 5 bit. So Y will be 5 bit number, and number will be 01, that is A, and B1, that is 0. This one is V0, V1, V2. So this one is V10, and C0, C1, C2, C3. 2 and 3 are 0 and 1. 0 and 1. So output will be 01001. Example for replication operator. Replication operator used for a number when we require a number for a number of times. Example is given here. A is required 3 times, B is required 2 times, and C is required for 1 times. So simple adding all the required numbers here. We have to take 3 times A, that is 01 01 01, and 2 times B, 01 01 01 01 10 10 4 C. Examples for relational operators. A less than B. A is 01, B is 101. So here condition is fulfill, so output Y will be 1. A less than equal to B, condition is also fulfilled, so output will be 1. For the input A equal to 01 and B 101. A greater than B, this is false condition, so output will be 0. A greater than equal to B, this is also the false condition, output will be 0. A less than B, here A is taken as 2 bit number 01 and B taken as 3 bit number, that is x01. So unknown value is coming here in B number, so output will be x, unknown value. Output of logical equality will be 0, 1 or x, while the output of case equality will be 0 and 1. Examples are given here. Y equal to A, case equal B. A is 001, B is 101. So A and B both are not equal, so output will be 0. A not case equal B. If A is x01, B is 101, x is coming in A number, so output will be x, because this one is unknown value. Y equal to A logical equal B. A is given here, x01, B is 101. So in logical equal, two values are exactly compared. If both are same, then output is 1, otherwise output will be 0. Here bit position 0 is 1, bit position 0 is 1, both are same. bit position 1 is 0, bit position 1 is 0, both are same. Bit position 2 is x, bit position 2 is 1. So these are not same, so output will be 0. Another example is A not logical equal B. A is x 0 1, B is x 0 1, both are same. It means output should be 0. So this condition is false, so output will be 0. Examples for bitwise operators. Y equal to not A. Suppose A is 4 bit number 1010. Bitwise not operation is performed here. 1 is 0, 0 is 1, 1 is 0, 0 is 1. That is not operation. A and B. A is 1001, B is 1010. Bitwise operation 0 and 1. That is 0. 1 and 0. That is 0. 0 and operation 0, 0. 1 and operation 1. That is 1. So output will be 1000. A or B. A is 1001, B is 1010. Then bitwise or operation bit position 0, 0 here, or operation with bit position 0, that is 1 here. So 1 or 0 operation or operation 1 or 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 or 1. 1. So output will be 1011. A XOR V. A is 1001, B is 1010. Bitwise XOR operation is performed here. 0 XOR 0. That is 1. 1 XOR 0. 1. 0 XOR 0. 0. 1 XOR 1. That is 0. So output will be 0011. A XNOR V. So output will be the reverse of this XOR function, that is 1100 for the same inputs A and B. Y and A. This operator is called reduction operator. It can be applied on a single operand, and single operand is here A. A is 1001. So AND operation is performed among the bits. That is 1 and 0 and 0 and 1. So output will be 0. Examples for shifting operators. A right shift by 2 bit position. Suppose A is 1010. Then after 2 right shift, number will be 0001. The 2 bit positions are vacant at the MSB side, and these are filled by the zeros. Second example, A left shift by 2 bit position. Again, the A is same, 1010, and number is left shift by 2 bit position. So here 2 bit position at the LSB side are empty, and these are filled by the zero values. A arithmetic right shift by 2 values. Arithmetic operations are used for the signed number systems, where MSB shows the signed bit. So in digital systems, the MSB 1 shows the negative sign, MSB 0 shows the positive sign. So in this case, when we are shifting the number towards right side, then MSB will be unchanged, and the empty positions are filled by the MSB bit. So in this case, when A is 1010, and it is shifted by 2 bit positions, MSB, that is 1, it cannot be changed because this one is showing the sign bit. So 1 is there, and 2 bit positions 0, 1 is shifted here, and these are filled by the MSB bit, that is 1. So number is 1110. Next example is A arithmetic left shift by 2 bit position, and here number is same, A is given 1010, MSB will be unchanged, that is 1, and number is shifting towards left side. wet to wet position, and the empty positions are filled by the zero values. So number will be 1000. Logical operators. Logical operators returns the values 0, 1 or x unknown values if x is there in any operand. Examples are there: y equal to logical not a. Suppose a is 1010, so it is not equal to 0. So it means the not operation of a will be 0. A logical and operation b. A is 1001 and b is 1010. Here a and b both are not equal to 0. It means high values or logic 11 are representing here. A is logical 1, b is logical 1. So AND operation of logical 1 and logical 1 is 1. So output will be 1. Next example is a logical AND b operation. Here a is 0 and b is not equal to 0. It means AND operation of logical 0 and logical 1. So output will be logical 0. A logical OR b. A is not equal to 0, b is not equal to 0. Logical 1, logical 1 OR operation. It means output will be 1. A logical b operation. Suppose a is 4 bit number 10x1, b is 4 bit number 1010. X is coming here in a number. Whenever x or z is coming in any operand, then output will be always x. Delay specifications. Verilog provides the facility for assigning the delays at certain points in a program. Hash sign is used for representing the delay. Example is given here: assign hash 5 y equal to a bitwise operation and b. Assign is a keyword and mostly used in data flow modeling style. Here y is the output, inputs are a and b. In this case, y appears after the 5th unit. Next concept is system task. So Verilog provides the system task for routine operations such as stopping, finishing, monitoring, displaying or noting the current time. System task always start with the dollar sign, and important system task keywords are display, monitor, stop, finish and time. These are frequently used system task keywords. Dollar display, simply displaying the values of variables or expressions. Here example is given: dollar display in a bracket, this is Verilog example. Double quoted text is the string. This string is printed at the output exactly because system task display is using here. Dollar display the value of y equal to percentage b a. Here the exact value is displaying at the output is the value of y equal to a. Percentage b is simply showing the binary equivalent number. Monitoring of the change values in Verilog is possible with the keyword dollar monitor. So dollar monitor example is given here: double quoted value of clock equal to percentage b clock. So here we are simply monitoring the clock pulse, and the clock is in binary number system. Stop simply used for putting the Verilog simulation in interactive mode. Then designer can we debug the program from the interactive mode, while dollar finish completely terminates the program. Has 50 dollar stop. When time unit 50 is reached, then program is stopped in interactive mode. Has 100 dollar finish. When time is reaching 200 unit, then program is terminated. Dollar time used for getting the current simulation time. Dollar time, it is simply showing the current simulation time at the output.